I was diagnosed in January 2011. To be honest, it was kind of a relief because I'd got so ill and I didn't know what was going on. And I could hardly do anything without almost kind of collapsing. I'm so in love with you. I had quite a rare cancer, so. And I think the more they can do to find out about it, the easier it will become to treat people and the more people will survive. So when I was eventually told that I had leukemia, even though it was quite a shocking thing, I knew something was going to be done to help me get better.
I'm Hannah Cottis, I'm one of the paediatricians working here in Exeter. Cancer Research is the charity works, like a lot of charities do, looking at all aspects of looking after patients. My time as a doctor, the diagnosis of cancer has changed from being something that was viewed to be a life-limiting condition. There are lots of patients, and I can't mention this patient's name, but it was a little two-year-old boy who I looked after when I was a doctor on the cancer ward in Bristol Children's Hospital. And he had something called an Ommaya reservoir, so a little connection in his head, inside his brain, and we used to have to take fluid off every day because he had an infection there. And we'd take fluid off and put antibiotics back in. And every day for half an hour I would sit there and drain fluid off this little boy's brain whilst his mother read books to him. And he died before he turned three, and he's probably the reason why I'm not a cancer doctor, I have to say, because it was very sad when he passed away. But he's one of lots of little children that you see go through this.